Well, good evening to you and welcome on this most perfect evening for a game of football. Conditions are absolutely splendid and the folk of this town have come out in their droves for this match. Why wouldn't they? It is an ideal circumstance for what could be an ideal game. Everybody has been attracted to it. It has been the talk of the town and the buses have been packed. Double-decker buses lining up outside. Coaches have carried thousands of away supporters here too. And all of it adds up to make it terrific, a crackling atmosphere. The match, I think, will be quite a spectacle.
It is quite a sight to behold. A massive sea of yellow and green and blue, the colours of the Brazilian flag.
Brazil have gone 4-3-3. How do you interpret that?
Yeah, Peter, you can look at this formation one minute and think that it is 4-3-3, and the next time you check it'll be 4-5-1. And it's all to do with whether you've got the ball or not, and the wider attacking players being asked to apply defensive discipline too. When it does turn to a 5 across midfield, then the shape of this team takes on a much tidier, compact defensive look.
Got things on the way.
Eric Botteguin.
Ronaldo.
And it's Fernandinho.
Rubinho. And he's going long.
Could be thinking about it.
He'll have it in! Big moment! Massive goal!
And some of the best managers I played for insisted on starting games as you mean to go on. And we've just seen a very important opening goal from an extremely talented individual who looks primed for more. He really does look at it.
Well, I think there's a few trying to claim offside, but he looks to have been on. Yeah, he was on.
Brazil take the early advantage. Good challenge, he just stood firm.
Robinho displaying his defensive capabilities there. That's no striker's tackle. You have to admire commitment like that, because he could easily ignore that and just kind of walk around and let others do all the chasing, but instead he looks as if he relishes the chance to dig in for his team here.
Just to get it forward quickly. Holt. Can he put it away? He's got away with one there. Lucas. Felipe. Brazil are already ahead. The perfect start.
Always when you score early, it gives you such a lift and it casts doubt in the mind.
Can he score? He scored! And already they're looking to run away with it. However many surrounded him, that is what he can do.
Well, I think that defence there thought they were in good position and they had him where they wanted, yet somehow he's worked the scoring position when it didn't see him on. It's really crafty business, that.
Brazil get themselves a two-goal cushion.
Well, unsurprisingly, Peter, the opposition look completely stunned. I'm not sure they can gather themselves.
Bernardinho with a good steal, well played. That's lovely. Oh, good interception. Out wide to the right. Ball needed to be better there. It's a wasted chance. Tried to play it through.
Peter, his body shape was a giveaway before he made the pass, and its obviousness was appreciated.
Diego sends that a long way. Hoists it high. Robinho gets into some space. Fernandinho. It's on a plate.
Oh, really got caught in a trap there, and he just couldn't get out.
Robinho, he's in, surely, shakes the chutes, they are rampant, and the lead is three, it is surely done.
And how about the timing of the pass and run? They've worked it before and no doubt they'll work it again.
Three without reply. This is becoming a stroll. El Ahmadi. And it's Amrabat. Dinks one in. Stitch defending, but that'll do. Just whacks it away. Chooses to go back. Tries lifting it over. Hits one! Oh, the keeper's done just about enough.
Well, his reaction to that was ultra sharp, Peter. His anticipation is in fine working order.
Been taken short. El Ahmadi. Amrabat.
Al Ahmadi tries to stroke it through. Diego gets it upfield. And it's Hulk. Hulk.
They didn't manage to get nearly enough into the box, and that speaks of little ambition.
And the finish! It's broken loose! Rubinho. Goalkeeper's ball.
Half-time, as easy as 1-2-3. It really has been that straightforward halfway through the match, but very little to suggest that much will change over the second half.
Peter, do I really need to say anything, or can I simply refer you to the scoreline?
Brazil, 3 goals to the good after a really excellent first half that's been intriguing to watch. Plenty of highlights to show you during the break.
Start of the second half. No changes at half time that we're aware of. Aimed long and direct. Chance to break. It's the through ball. Just brushed off the ball there. Rubinho. And the weighted pass. Get that clear. Well, there's going to be a change now with the ball out of play. Fernandinho. Hits one! And the ball's come out. Now the counter. Cut out in the nick of time. Ronaldo. Ronaldo! Keeper's not concerned by that.
Well, I think a little eagerness just got the better of him. He may have been thinking about back page headlines there.
Can't get the better of his opposite number. Rubinho. His creative best, he's set up 2 goals. Hulk can shoot it, and Hulk! Outstanding save to keep that out.
quick thinking and quick control, Peter, that creates a little more working space.
And it's Amrabat.
Fine defending there. Robinho. Now the breakaway.
They're actually not getting too tight, which is interesting.
No.
It's probably cautionary. Don't dive in, try to pinch it or intercept so nobody can get in behind.
Knocks it away.
And it's Amrabat.
El Ahmadi. Well, no doubt someone is being given special treatment here.
Yeah, and having notched a goal already, Peter, he's not going to be allowed to run off the shoulders as much as he'll want.
Great strength, too strong for his opponent. Keeper's got good distance on that.
Bonaccia
battles to win it back.
Bonaccia goes looking.
Amrabat.
Al-Ahmadi
drives forward with purpose. It's a brilliant interception. Away from immediate danger. Now the ball's come loose and the chase is on. Pings it out wide. Could move up a gear here. Looks to dink one in. And helps available out wide. Yeah, that does look a foul. Referee's given a free kick.
Well, it was deliberate, it was cynical, and you have to understand the frustration of being denied a clear opportunity, but it had to be done.
Well, that looks like a final warning. Still no card. Forward it goes. Gets wrestled off the ball. Floats one over. And it's hoisted clear.
Brazil really have been alive to interceptions and picking off any loose balls.
Last ditch defending, but that'll do. So, time for changes on both sides, actually.
Well, for me, this was the obvious substitution. He'd become just a little jaded, and as a result of that, he was most likely to make a mistake. I think sometimes when the body becomes tired, the brain goes with it, and I think that's happened in this case.
Boots it to safety. Tries to dink it in. He's made sure that that won't get through. There's a long ball. Ronaldo, Bonaccia, plays it out wide, he's got options out wide, both sides then taking this chance to turn to their benches. Now it's Amrabat. Lucas. Ronaldo. He's got away. Play for a goal kick. Back and they start again. There is the final whistle. Brazil, very much the dominant side, almost the only side Every time they've got on the ball, they look like scoring. It is a landslide. Your final thoughts, Jim?
Well, if ever there was a good tone setter for a football match, that was it. First minutes, first shot, first goal, and it set them up.
So just time for me to say thanks to Jim for his wisdom and to wish you all a very good evening. Very warm welcome to you on this most pleasantly clear evening. As you can see, we are getting through the pre-match formalities and processes, the players coming onto the field for the usual fanfare and handshakes and so on. Conditions absolutely perfect, temperatures are kind enough, it is an absolute picture under the floodlights here, and the match that follows ought to follow suit. This must be amongst the favoured arenas of supporters all over the world. It really does have a very special feel to it. Racing Club have been going through a pretty rough time of late. It is safe to say that their form coming into this game is not good at all.
Testing times lie ahead, Peter. The problem is that it's hard to draw on and...
Shapes for an overhead! It didn't come off, but an audacious effort.
Oh, that's fantastic improvisation he showed there. Adjusted himself very quickly, but it's rare that they come off.
Timely intervention. It upfield. Just brushed off the ball there. Throw in. has got good distance on that. Hit long and direct. Knocks it away. And that's been lever clear. It'll be a throw-in. It's Iaramendi. And it's hoisted clear. Can he? Has a hit!
Great ball to play him in, but he will be gutted to miss that.
That was created because of good, lively movement, which pretty much dictated the pass.
Racing Club are playing with a pleasing width here,
especially that front line.
Is it working for you?
It's not movement for the sake of it. Yes, it is working for me. There's a purpose to create space.
We've got a corner here. Played it short. He'll have a dip!
Worth a try. Shame about the outcome.
Well, it was certainly an acrobatic effort. I mean, it was probably the best option for him, but they're never easy to pull off.
Forward it goes. Well played, he saw that coming. To the keeper and go again. Keeper goes long. Floats one over. And that has been clubbed away. That'll be a throw in. Wrestled off the ball. Boca Juniors have conceded a few at around this time recently. Looking to stay solid now. Here it comes. Dashing forward at pace. He's played him through. He's got the ball. He's gone for it. Looking to break out here. Done very well to intervene. Out wide to the right. Keeps everyone guessing. Get it forward quickly. Aimed long and direct. And it's got through. Lovely feet. Can he put it away? It's broken loose. And he just whacks it away. Loose ball. Who's going to get there? Made sure that that won't get through. Gets it upfield. Defender's on the back foot. And he's made certain that won't get through. Lobs it in gently. He's had a look, and he's blown his whistle for half-time. So another team has broken through, but certainly not for the want of trying. It's been an interesting game up to now, but still goals. What do you think we're up to after 45 minutes?
Boca Juniors were actually very good on the front foot the first half, even if they have nothing to show for it.
After 45 minutes, it is still goalless. A change, perhaps, after half-time. The action has... And a shot! Saved only by poor finishing.
Well, Peter, I would say it was worth a try.
Boca Juniors suffered a frustrating loss last time, from which the boss is hoping for a reaction. Tries to get it forward quickly. Played into space out wide. Up to meet it! Knocks it away. And the ball's come out! Gonalo plays it backwards, and they'll try again. A chance to play it in. They've got it back as soon as they gave it away. Adebayor. He's got away. Hits one!
That's always a great sight, you know, on a football pitch. Nimble footed, show great balance and a really cool head to finish. And that kind of dribbling is really smart.
Racing Club, draw first blood here.
Oh, half-time has been a blessing for this team. You know, what a great start to the second half.
Iarramendi. Looking for space out wide. That's a good block, but at the expense of a corner. Lovely bit of skill. Crosses in a low one. Good clearance and very necessary.
Boca Juniors are definitely going about this the right way.
Well, this isn't the time to talk about risks now, Jim, is it? They just have to hurl everything at it and hope for a break.
Well, there's no two ways about it. This is what they have to do.
Great save, real class.
Rafael Sobis sparked a tremendous stop there, and I think it's fair to add, he just wasn't expecting it.
So the ball's gone out of play, and a change is upcoming. And that's been levered clear. Turns and goes back, and he's whipped it in low, gets good distance on it.
Yeah, maybe they've become a little desperate in falling into the trap of predictability here.
Good challenge, he just stood firm. He's looked long this time.
about up to 75 minutes. Your impression so far, Jim?
Well, there'll be no accusations of a lack of effort. They're giving as good as they get when it comes to chances.
Aimed low and direct. He's got the ball glued to his feet. Last-ditch defending, but that'll do.
This is good ball retention, and it should be enough from here, but they want to double their advantage.
Yaramendi. That's been won straight back.
There's a real appetite from them to finally put this game to bed, but will they?
Striding forward, looking to shoot. They've scored!
And how about the timing of the pass and run? They've worked it before, and no doubt they'll work it again.
They have got changes here, from both sides, in fact. Boca Juniors grab the equaliser, and we're all square.
Well, that goal just serves to give them the momentum and psychological edge now at this stage, but for me, they've got to chase a winner.
Oh, good interception. Well, that looks a foul. Yep, referee's given it. Keeper goes long. Racing Club desperately need a goal, and this could well be their last chance. What a throw in. Added time is up. And there goes the whistle. Well, no winner here, but an intriguing game. The result, probably a fair reflection. It has finished all square. Any reflections on what you've seen, Jim?
Boca Juniors must have viewed this game as very winnable, but will no doubt have a healthier respect for this opposition.
So many thanks to Jim Beglin. That's all we have time for. Good evening to you. Well, good evening to you, and welcome on this most perfect evening for a game of football. Conditions are absolutely splendid, and the folk of this town have come out in their droves for this match. Why wouldn't they? It is an ideal circumstance for what could be an ideal game.
Everybody has been attracted to it. It has been the talk of the town, and the buses have been packed, double-decker buses lining up outside. Coaches have carried thousands of away supporters here too, and all of it adds up to make it terrific, a crackling atmosphere. The match, I think, will be quite a spectacle. A U-shaped stand here at the Bombonera, draped in blue and gold. Truly, this can be a menacing place. And already we're underway here. Cueva is desperately calling for it out wide.
Oh, he's got a crucial block in there.
The defence got the better of him this time, but I'm sure he'll go again. Adebayor. And he's cut it out. Clears it out of harm's way.
Well, there's a lot of movement out wide now.
Yeah, you can certainly see that.
Well, I think it's a move to open the game up more, whether out wide or just getting a runner through the middle now.
What an adventurous run from a defender. Omar Al-Abdullawi really has been in sparkling form, hasn't he? No doubt we'll hear plenty of rumours about him when the transfer window opens.
I think so. He's a man very much in demand, and not just from any interested party. The big boys will be dipping into their very large pockets to try and prize this fellow away.
And the finish! And he nearly went all the way.
I just hope he won't let the failure to score affect him. With the ability he has, he can reproduce.
Change to the score, 0-0 it remains. Battles to win it back.
Yeah, that's top defending and preventing him turning, which can open up many possibilities.
Pretty clear, it is a foul. He has resisted the temptation to go to his pocket. It's just a stern lecture.
Yeah, well, they were exposed and vulnerable, and he knew he had to do something to prevent a goal then.
A real opportunity here from... He's gone to Rex! Up for the header! He's missed, but by that far...
I don't need to tell you he got underneath it, and there's only one place it can go.
It's come loose. Played back in. Out to the left it goes. Gone a long way up and away. And he's looking at the referee, but the referee is shaking his head. Forward it goes. Loose ball, who's going to get there? Pinged forward. El Abdullawi. Oh, it's opened up nicely. Big chance! And it's a goal!
Looking back at that, that's how you play on the counter. Quick and decisive and ruthless with the finish. I thought it was a stunning, stunning breakaway.
1-0 lead established.
Still a fragile lead, though. They can't afford to sit on this.
Out wide to the right.
He's left his mark.
Goes for goal! Great corner, and he did the rest.
Yeah, I just thought he wanted that more than anyone else on the pitch, and it was fully deserved. He gave it everything he had.
Complexion to the game.
Yeah, it's always a dangerous time when you've just scored. You can easily lose focus and then bang, you peg back again.
It's a loose ball. Cuevar. To stroke it through. Can he finish? Big relief, it just needed better contact.
Oh, it was the first touch to die for, and it set him up beautifully.
El Abdullahi. Can he put it away? They've scored! Front. Jim, your thoughts?
Well, he made it obvious as to where the pass should be played, Peter, and it made the finish look that bit easier.
Boca Juniors get themselves into the lead. Aimed long and direct. Ball's loose, who's getting there? And that's a foul, free kick's been given. First 45 minutes are up. So a really good half of football, three goals and just one separating them.
Well, it remains very delicately poised, and based on the promise we've seen through the first 45 minutes, I wouldn't be surprised if this takes another twist or two. It certainly would be in keeping.
Boca Juniors into the half-time break with a narrow advantage. It is 2-1. Already up and running for the second half. Whistle's gone, that's a foul.
Cuevar! Oh, that's brilliant! A finish of true class!
And it's another really good show of character. I love the spirit and togetherness they muster. Never know when they're beaten.
And he's produced a beauty. This is quite a battle.
Well, I think this is a case of anything you can do, we can do too. I mean, they're matching each other like for like here.
Boca Juniors, again hit early in the second half. It just keeps happening week after week.
Lanús, quick to defend their manager in the wake of criticisms levelled at him in recent days.
I think it was quite fair, the criticism he received. He was blind to an obvious problem, and he was far too slow in reacting to it. He was never going to get away with that. This defence just doesn't trust itself to play a higher line.
Frighten the people getting in behind.
Yeah, absolutely. It just opens up the opportunity of not only strikers getting behind, but the runners from midfield too.
Foul and a free kick in a very dangerous area.
Well, I think the alternative was to stand there and do nothing while he tried to score, and obviously he's not going to allow that, Peter, is he?
So a chance here, what can they make of it? So does he go for it?
He's beaten the keeper, but hit the post!
Clearance and very necessary.
And he's going long.
And helps available out wide.
And it's got through.
Gorgeous control there.
Danger averted for now.
Crunching tackle.
He's gone down, but the referee just tells him to get back up again.
Cuts it upfield.
Cuts it out.
He's in, surely. Shot a goal!
It's gone ever so well.
Oh, that's a sparkling save. Absolutely sparkling. His reflexes were ultra sharp.
Knocks it away. It's Iarum.
It's one!
He's done very well to get to that.
Well, as Tesco, Peter, the keeper, has just received an A-plus grade.
Gone for a throw-in.
Good challenge, he just stood firm. Challenge, but fair enough.
Look, this can still go either way. It might be...
Well, that looks a foul.
Yep, referee's given it.
And that's been well dealt with.
Lanús showing a good level of intensity at this stage. They're calling on all their resources now.
Going through,
turns and goes back,
chooses to go back,
going for goal!
That is wayward.
Oh, look, I don't want to sound too dismissive, but from here, that looks the harder thing to do.
Concentration levels are very good, and so is the commitment. This game could yet yield a winner.
Played out to the right.
Boca Juniors merit full marks for their attitude and application in trying to win this. It means an awful lot, obviously.
He's made certain that won't get through.
aimed long and direct.
Added time is up, and there goes the whistle. So it's ended in a draw. Craft and graft and everything apart from a winning goal.
Well, whatever time of day or night it is with you, welcome along to a game which is threatened, I have to tell you, by a rather forbidding weather forecast. The expectation is for quite heavy rain as the game grows older this evening. It hasn't arrived just yet, but it will do shortly. Glad to report, though, that that hasn't affected the crowd who are here in good number and indeed in good voice. And the game will be underway very soon. This place simply a monument to the game. So much prestige, so much pride, so much passion whenever football is played here.
Tries a header!
No, he couldn't get the direction he needed.
No, that was a slick move, and there were several options in the box to pick out.
He's managed to get that all wrong.
It's got through.
Cross deflected behind for a corner.
He's played it short. Aimed in towards the centre. And it's kept out by a stubborn defence.
There's been quite a few crosses coming in from that left-hand side. Look, it's the width that's provided.
It's one!
That's caused a worry or two.
A more than decent attempt, Peter.
Hoists it high.
Big chance! And he's done it! The breakthrough strike!
That's wonderfully done. Crisp hit, true finish.
Omar El Abdellaoui really showed his coolness, Peter, by not getting flustered on such a tough skill. And for me, it was controlled perfection.
Boca Juniors took the early advantage. Forward pass, cuts it out. Lobs it in gently. It was good pressing, forced the error to put an end to it before things could get even more threatening. Played out to the right. And it's Caceres. Deftly done. Caceres crosses in a low one.
forward it goes. El Abdullahi drilled in low.
Caceres gets good distance on it. Knocks it away.
Now a chance to break.
El Abdullahi.
Now they can break here. Well played, he saw that coming.
Gets it upfield.
Well, they would seem to be trying to expose the centre of that defence to runners.
It makes for some terrific movement.
It does, and they may be hit on the break because obviously it requires numbers forward to stretch them out.
And it's hoisted clear. Shoots! And he's there to hoof it away.
Hardly anything between the sides. And the score is 1-0. Looks to clip it forward.
Gets it back.
He's made sure that that won't get through.
Breaks on here.
And he's going long.
Let's put a stop to that. Plays it out to the flank.
Oh, well intercepted. Really alert to the danger. Out wide to the right. He's through. Oh, he's in!
Can he put it away?
Keeper's ball.
Caceres.
But finds himself back in the starting side for the first time in a while. Boca Juniors are leading with half-time drawing close.
That's a good block, but at the expense of a corner.
Attempt,
just the wrong outcome.
That's a little unfortunate. He had a lot of people worried then.
It's wrestled off the ball.
And he's searching through.
Has a hit!
And he just whacks it away.
Shots! Oh, taken with style! A two-goal lead and they're firmly in control.
What about that, Jim Beglin?
I just think it's clever positioning from clever movement, and when all of that is synchronised with the right pass, that's what happens.
Boca Juniors
get themselves a two-goal cushion.
Well, at 1-0, this contest was still nicely poised, but now that it's gone to 2, mindsets are affected a lot more. Winning belief one way and that losing feeling the other.
Good running with the ball. Can they build on it? Oh, sweet feet.
Cut out in the nick of time.
The first half is done. Any opinion you'd like to express on the first half?
Well, it's looking pretty straightforward, Peter. They've got themselves into a very good position, so why dither from here when they can repeat their first half success with another show of strength?
Boca Juniors go in at half-time on a comfortable two-goal cushion.
Underway again.
No changes at the interval from either side.
Boca Juniors settled for a point from that gripping game last time out. Omar El Abdullahi. Adebayor
attempts to play it through.
had a shot!
Caceres.
Aimed long and direct.
Going through.
Adebayor.
Steered out wide, but he won't reach that one. Caceres. Tries to get it forward quickly. Try as they might, they just couldn't get into an attacking area. That's a decent ball.
This defence is wary about opposition pace.
So they're just not getting too tight?
Yeah, they know that if they step up, their keeper could get a whole lot busier.
He's left his man. Caceres is charging up on the overlap. That's been repelled. Looking for a decent ball in. Loose ball, who's going to get there? Boca Juniors haven't made a substitution yet. He's played him through. Shoots! Yes! And the lead is three! It is surely done! Well, you've got to say, the odds on him missing from there were very slim.
Yeah, and teamwork was key to that. A beautiful piece of engineering to set him free in the box.
Boca Juniors take a three-goal lead and they are romping out of sight. Tries to get it forward quickly. Pushes it out wide. Forward it goes. And now the breakaway. He's found his man. And that's left him on the seat of his pants. Both sides then taking this chance to turn to their benches. Up to meet it! Went with his head but couldn't steer it in. Caceres appears to be in some real discomfort. Is it his leg?
Yeah, and the manager's concerned too. Substitution time perhaps, or maybe not, we'll see.
But he is going to soldier on by the looks of it. Aimed long and direct. And that is as far as they're going to go. And now they can launch a counter. Done very well to intervene. Adebayor, more than happy to take the muscular approach.
Bart simply had to make that count, and he did it with some authority too. Wonderful.
Success. Looking to shoot. Oh, the ball's come loose. That's one way of trying to make things happen. There's a few who could follow that example. He's got away. El Abdullahi. Can he finish? Big relief. It just needed better contact.
Well, he did get himself into a good position. Something for him to cling to.
Here it comes. He's left his man, striding forward, facing... He's had a goal! Rapidly approaching the end. Well, the three-game winning streak is coming to an end, it would seem. And the counter is on. Not much subtle. It's an untidy challenge. Free kick given. Yellow or red? It is red. Well, there may be some scope for debate over the seriousness of the offence, but none over its repercussions. We'll have to see out the rest of the game with 10 men.
Yeah, it would seem a little too far out. This will probably be a dink far post.
And he should have made it four. It's been taken straight back. Tries to dink it in. Dashing forward at pace. Confirmation that there will be 2 minutes stoppage time. Tries to get it forward quickly. Success. And there goes the final whistle. Boca Juniors, winners of a no contest. They just swamped their opponents in superior quality.
Well, after all of that, Jim, what are you thinking?
Boca Juniors have some very strong runners from midfield, and it's not often you'll see a team be so effective by...
very good evening to you as you join us for tonight's live game. Unfortunately, the weather for it is forecast to be less than ideal. We are expecting intermittent spells of heavy rain, which just might impact on the quality of the football. I don't think it's going to be sufficient to prevent the football from being played, nor indeed has it deterred the many, many fans who are in here and already generating a terrific atmosphere ahead of the game, which kicks off any moment now. The experience here at the Bombonera, almost beyond description. Feels like one of those things you have to experience for yourself. The lineup we have suggests it's going to be a 4-5-1 formation, Jim.
Well, if you want to secure a clean sheet, Peter, this is a very good way of going about it. It adds discipline and lends a stubbornness to that midfield, which can stifle opposition attempts to play through, and it takes a lot of pressure off your defence, of course. Forces longer passes through the aerial route. So, all things considered, that extra layer across midfield is highly, highly effective.
We have already started here. Played into space out wide. Can he shoot? And he's cut it out. And he's there to hoof it away. The referee's awarded a free kick. That's the throw. Aimed long and direct. And that's been levered clear. Forward it goes.
Banfield have made it clear what they're trying to do for me, Peter.
What are they trying to do?
Well, I think they're making the pitch as big as possible to work both flanks into better supply routes.
Maitland-Niles. It's come loose.
This game is in need of some excitement. It needs help, and it's down to the creative and striking talent to up their game and give this crowd something to cheer about.
Lovely bit of skill there. Here it comes. That was asking just too much of him. Plenty of appeals, but the referee is not interested. Boots it to safety. Big chance here. He's not going to get that. Make
Declan Lyles.
Tries to get it forward quickly.
Great strength, too strong for his opponent.
Boca Juniors have been susceptible to late first half goals over recent weeks, so determined not to concede this time. And he just whacks it away. Just little by way of goal mouth action yet. Plays it out to the wing. This is promising. He's got away. Is it in? And he's done it! First blood drawn. With time and space aplenty, he was never going to miss.
Well, he made it obvious as to where the pass should be played, Peter, and it made the finish look that bit easier.
Banfield take the lead, 1-0.
Yeah, and they know there's plenty of work left in this one, Peter, before they can actually say that the job is over.
Boca Juniors are found wanting again as the first half draws to a close. Oh, well defended, that had to be done. Hoists it high. Referee brings the first half to a close.
And there we are, off they go for half-time. The breakthrough did indeed come in the first half, but there has only been that one goal. It is very, very tight.
Well, they definitely won't be happy with that half. They seem to lack a bit of desire, especially going forward. It wouldn't surprise me to see a change or two.
start of the second half.
Boca Juniors don't need to press the panic button just yet. They may have to tweak their setup first. If they don't grab an early goal in this second half, they can't hold back though.
Banfield, his last result owes so much to the astuteness of their manager.
But Peter, you just can't argue with the substitutions. They were spot on, and the timing of each were perfect too. That sort of decisive management is a winning formula in itself.
Caught offside that time.
It doesn't take much sometimes, Peter. He has to adjust a little mistimed run.
Omar Alabdallawi is the most accurate finisher in the side. Well, he acknowledges that he should have come up with something better there.
Omar Alabdallawi encouraged the pass with an intelligent run, but the pass just lacked pace.
Boca Juniors still trailing by one and looking here to take it up a notch after the break. Omar Alabdallawi gets it back. Well, needless to say, he was expecting a better ball than that. Aimed long and direct.
This defence just doesn't trust itself to play a higher line.
Frightened of people getting in behind.
Yeah, absolutely. It just opens up the opportunity of not only strikers getting behind, but the runners from midfield too.
And it's got through. Lovely bit of skill. And it's hoisted clear.
Boca Juniors showing a little more urgency now, and to be honest, Peter, this is what's required.
Jim, there's not too much subtlety or sophistication about this. It really is a question of needs must.
Spot on, Peter.
So far, Jim?
Well, at the moment, their chances of getting back in contention look slim. They're not exerting enough pressure. Simple as that.
And he's got good distance. Who's chasing? Goes for goal! Surely this time, really well taken goal. He was really quick to react to the initial save, and he has his reward.
Yeah, his instinct told him that the keeper would struggle to cope with that, so top marks for him following up. I think it's really sharp play, it was well read, and he was a little quicker than everybody else.
A change that was in the offing. Last one allowed. Casemiro is looking to make a big first impression here.
And that has added a whole new complexion to the game.
Look, get your seatbelts on, because this is showing all the signs of another roller coaster ride.
Going through.
Concentration levels are very good, and so is the commitment. This game could yet yield a winner.
Goes long.
Has a hit! They've scored! They've done it! It was coming! They have their reward!
Oh, a goal of real quality. He made it look ridiculously easy.
Well, most of those go high and wide because of their difficulty. He made it look like he does it every day.
Final checks on the touchline. A change about to occur.
Well, his stamina was called into question then, but there's absolutely nothing wrong with his heart and the effort he put in. He was very willing, though, not quite able.
Boca Juniors take the lead.
No doubt as to who has the momentum here now. The only doubt is how many is coming.
Keep calm and carry on. That's the job in a nutshell now.
Over to the left. Not much subtlety, he's launched himself there.
Boca Juniors are looking to make this one safe. They want to reduce the risk.
Out wide to the right. Looking for space out wide. And he's there to cut it out.
Oh no, it's an own goal!
Well, that wasn't in the script, and you have to feel for him, Peter. It's ended in some embarrassment.
Changes then in quick succession.
I think you have to admire his willingness to keep plugging away, but the manager has done him a big favour, I think, by taking him off. You know, he was looking very, very leggy.
Banfield, some help from Lady Luck there. They all count.
Iarramendi.
Forward it goes. Aimed long and direct. Stitch defending, but that'll do. Knocks it away. And it's El Abdellaoui. To shoot,
and he duly delivered.
It's rarely a problem when that much time is afforded in the penalty box. Nobody sensed where the danger was lurking, and the finish was made a lot easier.
Boca Juniors. So that's it. It is all over. Boca Juniors did it the hard way. A testament to their great powers of recovery. They have defied the odds.
thrilling, nail-biting, perhaps frustrating until the very end, but we do have a winner.
Well, I just think that determination and persistence has paid off handsomely to squeeze the win out of a draw. Sometimes it comes down to grit and desire and the stubbornness to keep plugging away. And this has been great staying power.
So thank you very much, Jim, for joining me. That brings us to the end of our coverage. So from us both, a very good evening.